Welcome back. This is Eric, the Friendly Viking. We are playing Rogue Legacy. Let's start out. So this is the first time we get to pick a character. Let's see, who should we be? Lady Chun-Li, the mage, with no negative traits. A mage with dementia, no. Baldness and stereo blind. Well, I really dislike stereo blind. As much as I don't like mages, it seems like they really want me to have a mage. So I'll take Lady Chun-Li, the bearded mage, the bearded lady. Spend some of this money I got from that first playthrough. Buy a smithy, because you have to buy a smithy. Not much choice there. We'll improve our health. And upgrade my knight into a paladin. Now I can block. That's pretty rad. Upgrade the mana. Upgrade equipment. Now we have some options here. Enchantress is more important to the than the architect, I should say. It's pretty epic stuff. Alright. You can enchant your body. Oh, yes. Wow, I did not know. Who knew? What else do we got here? We can upgrade the mage. We should probably... Oh, man, don't have any money. So we should probably do that, seeing as we're playing a mage. Well... Cest Lavis. Maybe you can help me. I used to be the greatest blacksmith in all the lands, but one day the monsters of this castle attacked my smithy and stole all my blueprints. Aw, you poor guy. Without those blueprints, I can only make cutlery and stuff. Oh, that's no good. Only so many forks to sell in these neighborhood, eh? Please bring back any blueprints you find, and I can build the most amazing equipment ever! Ever! Wow. At a price, of course. Oh, okay, so I'll bring you... blueprints, and then you'll charge me for them. That's capitalism at its best. Did I forget anything here? Yeah. Alright, so I don't have money for any of that shit. Excuse me. Hello, hero. Could I borrow your ear for a moment? I'm in need of help. I used to be a very powerful enchantress. But one day, the monsters of this castle invaded my dreams and stole my knowledge! They encased that knowledge in runes, and without those runes, I suck at my job! Please, hero, if you find any runes, bring them back to me, and then I'll sell it back to you at a profit. Again, with this ruthless capitalism. I love it. I love it. No, actually, runes are pretty important. Runes are what lets you double jump and stuff. Charon! One must pay the toll. Give him all of my money. Well, it's not like I can say no. Get out of here. What a jerkwad. Alright. Entering the castle proper. Money? Oh, yep, that's a teleporter pad. So this door's interesting. If y'all haven't seen a Let's Play before of this game, or you don't know what's going on, this is where you fight the final boss, and there's four mini-bosses you have to fight. Here's the map. Tower is always up. That's kind of like level 2. Forest is always to the right. Tower's level 3. Forest would be level 2. Dungeon would be level 4. And the castle, which we are in, would be level 1. So, journal entry level 1. The Prince's Journal. So this is the ongoing story. Treason. An assassin has wounded my father, the king. To bring order back to the kingdom, he has sent my siblings and I on a quest to save him. Together, we will venture into the cursed woods and enter Castle Hamson. This cursed castle has stood on the edge of the woods since time immemorial. But tonight, I will get a head start over my brothers and sisters and set forth on my quest while they lay asleep. To fail this quest would be an embarrassment to my name. All right. Oh. Lots of bad guys there. Ooh, treasure chest, too. All right, be ballsy here. Ow! Oh man, this is bad. I shouldn't have done this. I'm sorry, guys. Oh, God. Please stop killing me. Oh, I'm so dead, guys. Yep, there it is. And there is the shortest life ever. That's why I don't play Archmages. I killed 3 whole blue dudes. Well, let's just skip ahead right now. Paladin Muscle Weak is kind of lame. Knave that's stereo blind. I just can't stereo blind. A game mage. If you weren't a mage, don't mind your gay. Muscle Weak, the Paladin. So Muscle Weak means I'm not going to knock people back as far, which is pretty crappy. And, oh yeah, I made 20 gold, so I'm not going to be doing anything good there. Alright, so this video is going to run a little bit longer than the last. I don't want to just cut it off every time I die, especially in these early games. That's going to take for... Well, we'll have a bunch of two-minute videos, and nobody wants to watch a two-minute video. So I think I'm going to try to do this video around 15 to 20 minutes, depending on how the game responds. Alright, entry one. We've already seen this. Blah, 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 blah. We already read this. I don't care. Oh, and then I decided to read it again, because... That's how I roll, dog. Okay, that's right. That is a... Whoa! I don't like that room. Let's get out of there. You don't scare me. You, ow. Muscle weak. I don't knock people back. See how that's bad? See how they just kind of... Woo-hoo-hoo! Danger zone. All right. Muscle weak. Very bad. Very negative trait to have. We can just pogo this guy to death. Oh! No, maybe not. Alright. Alright. Just kind of give them the old back and forth. They never saw that coming. I could exchange my... I really like the one I have, but I think Chakram is a little bit easier to use. So, and I need to remember that I have my block now. So, okay. This should be good. Should restore some health. Yes, very nice. Oh, see, that was one of those times. Shoot! I really should have. Ooh, remembered. Oh, alright, here we go. So, I'm playing not great, but that's okay. Alright. So, we're just backtracking a little bit. I think I'm going to explore up first, and then I'll just poke my head up here, poke my head over here, check the map. Yeah, let's go. This is so much more dangerous when you don't have a double jump. So what I really want to find is a fairy chest, which is like a puzzle room, kind of. Ow! And the fairy chests are in these little puzzle rooms. And they kind of have a special requirement that you have to do to get them. So, for example, there's fairy chests where you have to get the chest within 5 seconds, or kill all the enemies, which are, like, totally the easiest ones to see, and that was bad. I could have used my paladin power and not taken that damage. But this game kind of have a scaling difficulty. It's called Rogue Legacy because it's a roguelike light, I guess would be the right way to say it. Roguelikes kind of punish you and kill you over and over again. This one has the advantage of the money that you use to unlock stuff. Those unlocks carry over. So I'm going to take this barbarian. Barbarians have a weaker attack, but they do a lot more, or they have a lot more health. So it's kind of a good thing to take. Let's unlock this side. Now, I didn't really want an architect, but I wanted to unlock the other stuff on this side. So architects like you lock down stuff. It's not great unless you're trying to kill a boss and you're really just doing not great. And you need that extra help. So I could upgrade the barbarian here, but I don't have the money. So let me just upgrade my health, because we haven't unlocked anything else. So no need to talk to any of these people. Here's the architect. I think he takes a percentage, like 20%, 15%, depends. I'm not sure. So you get like 80% of your overall gold. So every 10 gold, you only get 8. Not great, but like I said, if you're just trying to fight that boss, it's more convenient than having to clear an entire level to just, you know, to find the doorway to fight the boss. So, oh, let's see, there we go. I'm doing not great again, but that's all right, because I'm a nice guy. I didn't want to hurt those people. They made me. It's not my fault. So let's just get through here, get some loot, kill this zombie down here. Zombies are jerks. They like to talk smack about people's mamas. And so we put them down harshly. So I like to do that. Just kind of peek my nose up into next room. Sometimes it's just a little, like, one room that doesn't connect anywhere else. So it's really important to just kind of see, like, that one. There's a treasure there. But I think you have to be a dwarf to get it. Yeah, see, that little different colored tile there. Woo, this is gonna be fun. I shouldn't be doing this. I should not be doing this. Not on this character. Let's get out of here. So those guys are just a mini boss. Anytime you fight a mini boss, the first time you kill them on a playthrough, they drop a cool chest that will either give you a recipe for an item or just a whole ton of gold. All right, and I should play smarter. So I'm playing smarter here. You might notice I'm gonna kill. You could call it gaminess, but I'm gonna kill people from below, so they don't even have a chance to really hit me. So it's important to get all these little things. I mean, it doesn't look like much, but it really does add up. And you occasionally do get that 100 gold bag. I don't really like this room, but I'm gonna come. Let's kill this guy because he wanted to be separate from the group. Let's come see if we can get this treasure chest. It looks too good to be true, and much like in life, in this game, if it's too good to be true, it probably is. Pretty sure that's a haunted painting. Oh, it's not a haunted painting. Just gotta kill a bunch of zombies, that's all. Woo, money! That money's good stuff. Alright, what's over here? An exit. Alright, there we go. It's kind of a bad habit for my solo play. I'll try to get rid of it as I'm doing this playthrough for the Let's Play, because I'm sure that y'all don't need to see the map all the time. It's gotta be kind of annoying. Ow, crud. Hup! Just kill this guy real quick. And sometimes you just need to power through him like that. Ooh, I only got 16 health. Okay, so now this room right here, you'll see this often. This means to the right's probably the forest. Yep, to the left is the forest as well. I'm going to go pray at that guy right there. Yeah, so both forests. So these rooms, always on the left you get a health, and on the right you get a mana potion. I believe if you're gay, that's swapped. And that's the only thing that happens if you're gay and you have that trait, is that the mana and health potions are swapped. So this looks like a... Ooh, there's two of them. This is kind of scary, guys. I'm going to try to sneak this chest real quick and see if I can get out of here. Ooh! Yeah! Chakram! Okay. I don't like it. Oh, man. That's bad. Okay, I'm just going to have to leave. I'm going to come back again. Over here. Yeah, there you go. Okay. Uh-huh. Okay, I'm out of mana. That's bad. Yep. So it's just three. It's not that bad. It's just that they're big. Okay. Now, it's going to be even easier because it's just the three. It's not six coming at me every time. Hup. Get him. Get that Solok. Solok. Oh, man. He's just out of range. So we're just going to have to dodge. A couple of fireballs will be fine. It's just three fireballs. And then he's gone and he explodes into gold. And we can get this gold up here. So yeah, I really shouldn't be in the forest. This is probably kind of dumb, but I mean, look, I'm already up to 1,200 gold. That's, the money here is so much better. It's just really, really dangerous. And like I said before in that first video, this is kind of like level 2, and so I'm kind of skipping ahead just because I'm greedy. And everybody knows in video games, greed is usually rewarded with a heinous, gruesome, horrible death. I'm gonna go this way. Let's go up and away. See, if I was a dwarf, I could skip that whole little shebangeries. Alright. Whoa! Ow! Snap! I was not looking at that. Try to get that guy dead. Ooh. Pucker me up a little bit on that one. Alright. Now these eyeballs are annoying but easy to deal with. Alright. So later on, those horses are trailed by fire trails, like their hoof prints are fire, and that sucks. So right now, they're not that bad. Come here, Chain Tor. Whoop! Whoop! So that's a double jump right there would have killed him. But yeah, so, I mean, like I said, it's pretty worth it. Woo-hoo-hoo! Plus, it's just super fun to have that higher level of difficulty. Yeah, you know, hanging out in the forest at level 8. Probably dumb. But fun, much like most dumb things. Oh, whoa! This room is going to be difficult to dodge those. Oh, especially with one. Ow! Shoot! Well, actually, that's not bad. We're just under 16 minutes, so look at that rack of monsters. That's the best I've done so far on camera. So thanks for watching once again. This is the Friendliest Viking. My name is Eric. Appreciate your watching. Thanks for your time. If you liked it, like it. Please leave a comment below. Any suggestions or comments as they were. And thank you for watching. Once again, this has been Eric the Friendly Viking.